Hi readers, I'm here to talk to you today about a book I finished recently, Bluebeard by Kurt Vonnegut. I have not read a lot of Vonnegut, and what I have read, I read so long ago that this is almost a new approach to the author for me. I picked this particular book up primarily because of the allusion to Bluebeard's tale, and also because this is a book about art. This is a satire on art movements, most particularly the abstract expressionists. And it's also a phony autobiography of a character named Rabo Karabekian. Rabo Karabekian was also a minor character in an earlier Vonnegut novel called Breakfast of Champions. And here, the focus is on Karabekian. He's a 71-year-old curmudgeon. He is an artist, a painter, and he is looking back on his life. He is looking back on his failures. He feels like a failure in just about every area. He doesn't feel very good about himself. He doesn't feel very good about art in general. In fact, at one point he has given up art. And this word counterfeit, it comes up again and again. It's part of the commentary. And Rabo Karabekian, his skill as an artist, as a painter, is to capture what's in front of him very realistically, almost photographically. And he comes to think of that as counterfeit. And, you know, are you a real artist if all you're doing is capturing what's in front of you and replicating what you see? Or do you need to be doing something that is, you know, an expression of what you see? Is that what makes you a real artist? So he has quit painting a long time ago. Now, Rabo Karabekian has a secret. This is where Bluebeard's tale comes in. Rabo Karabekian has an old barn on the property, a potato barn. And there is something in that barn. We don't know what it is. We suspect it has something to do with art. We don't know if it's something that Karabekian has painted, or if he is hiding masterpieces that were brought over after World War II. We don't know. We just know he's got the potato barn locked up. He won't let anyone go in there. He won't let anyone see. He just, you know, don't ask. So of course, we as the reader, the entire time, the entire book, you're wondering, what's in the potato barn? Okay, just can't get away from that. So again, that's where the Bluebeard's tale comes in. You know, we get drawn into the tale ourselves because we become Bluebeard's wife, wanting to know what's in the potato barn. So I don't want to spoil too much more of the book for you. I do want to say that, again, this is one of his more human novels. Some people describe it as sweet, and I would just say it's more human. And towards the end, Vonnegut does something that surprised me very much. I was so pleased. I just sat in awe of his story, the way he was telling the story, what he was doing with it. I was just in awe. That's all I can say. And I highly, highly recommend this book to people, to just about anybody. If you have an interest in art, you'll like it. If you like satire, you'll like it. If satire and barbed wit bothers you, it's not terribly heavy in this. Again, it's one of his more human novels, and like I said, some people would describe that it has a certain sweetness to it. So I can recommend this to just about anybody. And I'm kind of curious if anyone else has read this book. What were your thoughts? Let me know what those are. And until next book, bye-bye.